Meteorologist Heather Waldman is tracking the fire and the latest conditions. KCRA 3's Kelly Curran and Erin Heft are live near the fire lines with the very latest updates from crews on the ground. But first, let's begin with Erin. And Erin, what are you seeing at this hour?
Leticia, that wind picking up in the last 5 minutes or so, really dispersing all of that smoke. We're seeing a lot of smoke that's billowing on the back side of this ridgeline. But if we just expand the camera view, you can just see how large this char mark is as the sun rose this morning. Now, for some perspective, we're on closed areas right now along Interstate 580 and South Corral Hollow Road. This, like I said, a part of the evacuation zone. And this, a grass fire. It moves very quickly. They ignite really easily and they burn out quickly as well because they're kind of a very easy to burn fuel. They ignite and then they go out, but they move very quickly, especially if wind is an element. And wind is kind of picking up this morning. We're not seeing any active flame from our vantage point, but we are seeing that smoke disperse really quickly in the last 10 minutes or so. The last update, as we've been repeating over the last hour, is the acreage, according to Cal Fire, has grown to 12,500 acres, sitting at 15% containment. Yesterday afternoon, when the Corral Fire was announced, it was around 2 o'clock. And it was under 500 acres, so jumping well into the 12,500 in about 17 or 18 hours. We're seeing resources from across the region here in Tracy, obviously, San Joaquin County, Alameda County, Livermore, and Mountain House. And we're seeing so many Cal Fire trucks, those wildland fire Cal Fire trucks that have the ability to spray from that front bumper. That's really helpful because they can actually roll through lands that look like this while spraying, moving forward. And that's in large part how they fight these fires. You're actually looking southwest at the fire right now. And according to Caltrans that we spoke to here, they say that fire line, that char mark, is about 8 to 10 miles long. And Kelly Curran is actually in the zone that we're pointing to in the south area of this fire right now. Leticia.
Erin, thank you so much for your live report this morning. And let's check in with KCRA 3's meteorologist Kelly Curran, who's also at the scene with a different vantage point. And Kelly, what's your exact location?
Yeah, so right now we are near 580 and Bird Road. We're just a little bit off of that onto a dirt road where we're seeing a lot of fire crews heading through, but we're also pretty close to 580 here, and you can see all of the char marks. Now, this is right where the fire actually jumped 580 briefly. As we were coming down here, we were able to see at least some char marks on the east side of 580, but most of it is on the west. I also want to show you this area down here where you can see that there are still plenty of shrubs that didn't burn, but the grass right here where we're standing is completely black, totally charred. But that shows you how fast this fire was burning and that a lot of these shrubs really didn't catch. It was just the grass and it was moving very, very quickly. So right now we're continuing to watch Cal Fire crews head their way toward the fire line itself, which is a little bit further west down this road, this dirt road here. It looks like it's possibly a private drive. We've seen about two trucks full of fire crews. It looked like maybe some hotshot teams that were heading down this road. Also several earth movers that were heading down. It looks like set up some fire lines. It looks like there's another one right here. So it looks like we've got about five or six of those vehicles that are heading down there to create fire lines as well. And we'll have more updates throughout the show.
And Kelly, although it looks calm right now and people may be watching and saying, why should I leave? Things that look pretty calm now. What's the message from fire crews on this fire?
You know, it's really better safe than sorry in that situation. I mean, as far as what we've been able to see since we've been here, like I said, a huge crew presence responding and heading down that road toward the fire. I've also seen the biggest plume of smoke continue to move southward. So it looks like even though where I'm standing, the wind isn't that much of a problem, it looks like as I head just a little bit further to the west, it is still moving pretty quickly. And hopefully all these crews can get things out. But yeah, I mean, there are definitely some homes in this area, and it would be a situation of better safe than sorry, especially if those winds start picking up a little bit later. We know that they can get going, and it doesn't take much to get these grass fires spreading once again. Leticia.
Kelly, thank you so much for your live report this morning. Let's bring in meteorologist Heather Waldman, who's tracking the fire conditions right now, and firefighters are facing a lot of challenges today.
Yeah, and as Kelly just said, grass fires on their own, even on a calm day, they can spread really quickly.
just because the grass itself ignites really quickly and burns really fast. So let's go over where the fire started yesterday afternoon. This is Corral Hollow Road in southwestern San Joaquin County. The fire started in the hills just to the north. I'll turn the map here so you can kind of get an eye of the or a view of the terrain. This is the Coast Range. The Altamont Pass, as some refer to it as, and this is where winds can really get funneled, especially when we have these onshore winds like we had yesterday and like the San Joaquin Valley we'll see again today. So here's how the fire spread, growing very rapidly overnight and into early this morning. Westerly winds pushing it to the east and to the south. So Erin's live shot was here right at the intersection of 580 and Corral Hollow Road. And we saw Kelly farther to the south on the southern edge of the fire. This is Bird Road, which is what she was referring to, where the fire very briefly skipped over 580. But it looks like fire crews were able to use Bird Road as kind of a built-in fire break there. Let's take a look at the winds. They've backed off some. As you saw, the differences between Kelly's shot and Erin's shot, we've got these little microclimate winds set up. So depending on where the fire is burning, obviously the winds are going to have some different effects. But here are the forecast wind gusts for some areas to the north of the fire. Unfortunately, we don't have an official observing spot or forecast spot close to the fire itself, but it gives you a general idea. Winds through this morning gusting between 15 and 20 miles per hour. But watch what happens this afternoon into this evening. See this bright patch here? This is an area that just very easily the geography funnels the winds and makes for faster winds where the fire ignited yesterday, pushed it farther off to the south and east. So we'll be watching out for similar conditions later this afternoon into this evening, where you see in the purple area, that's where winds may be gusting over 35 miles per hour. And Leticia, that would be the biggest challenge for fire crews trying to get a handle on this fire as the wind picks up.